Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. Aircraft carriers are one of the most important strategic assets of a nation. These vessels can be used to project power far beyond a country's coastline. But because of the very high cost, complicated construction process, and elaborate operational requirements, only a few countries possess aircraft carriers and have plans to develop more in the future. In this video, Defense Updates looks at upcoming aircraft carriers from 5 countries. Let's get started.
Number 5.
Article 9 of the Japanese Constitution dictates that Tokyo will forever renounce war as a sovereign right of the nation. Land, sea, and air forces, as well as other war potential, will never be maintained. Under its strictly defense-oriented policy, Japan has maintained that it cannot possess attack aircraft carriers, saying the vessels can be deemed offensive weapons that exceed the minimum capacity Japan needs for self-defense in light of the Constitution. But Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's government has altered the nation's post-World War II security policy over the past few years, most notably through new security laws that largely expand the range of activities permissible by Japan's self-defense forces. Japan is not constructing an aircraft carrier outright, but in what could be a major change in Japan's policy on aircraft carriers, the Defense Ministry is mulling a plan to buy F-35B stealth fighter jets for use on its helicopter carriers, which will be modified to work as full-fledged aircraft carriers. Japan's Izumo class is officially a helicopter carrier class, meant to carry rotary blade aircrafts of different types, but as some experts have indicated, the Izumo class has the capability to work as a traditional aircraft carrier after some upgrades. Izumo class has 2 vessels, Izumo and Kaga. Izumo was commissioned on the 25th of March 2015 and Kaga entered service on the 22nd of March 2017. Izumo class displaces 27,000 tons when fully loaded. These ships have a speed of 30 knots or 56 kilometers per hour. Each ship carries up to 28 aircrafts.
Number 4.
India currently operates INS Vikramaditya, which is a modified Kiev-class aircraft carrier that entered into service with the Indian Navy in 2013. Originally built as Baku and commissioned in 1987, the carrier served the Soviet Navy and later with the Russian Navy. INS Vikrant, IAC-1, is the first aircraft carrier built in India and the first Vikrant-class aircraft carrier being built for the Indian Navy. Work on the ship's design began in 1989 and the keel was laid in February 2009. The carrier was floated out of its dry dock on the 29th of December 2011 and was launched in 2013. As of now, the ship is being fitted out, expected to be completed by 2023, according to the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, though the Indian Navy still hopes to partially commission the ship in late 2018. The deck is designed to enable aircraft such as the MiG-29K to operate from the carrier. It's expected to carry an air group of up to 30 aircraft, which will include up to 24 to 26 fixed-wing combat aircraft. INS Vishal, IAC-2, is the follow-on Vikrant-class aircraft carrier and is currently in its design phase. It's intended to be the first supercarrier to be built in India. The proposed plan of the second carrier class is a new design, featuring significant changes from INS Vikrant. It will include an increase in displacement to 65,000 tons, as well as potential inclusions of EMALS Kadobar system. It will be able to carry 50 to 55 fixed and rotary wing aircrafts and is planned for commissioning in 2030.
Number 3.
In May 1997, the newly elected Labour government launched the Strategic Defense Review, SDR, which re-evaluated every weapon system active or in procurement with the exception of the Eurofighter Typhoon and the Vanguard-class ballistic missile submarines. One of the important outcomes of the report was that the government intended to replace the current carrier force with two larger vessels capable of deploying up to 50 aircraft, including helicopters. This decision was taken to augment the strategic capability of Royal Navy and ultimately led to the development of Queen Elizabeth-class carrier. The Queen Elizabeth-class can be described as supercarrier as they will displace approximately 70,600 tons. It's over three times the displacement of its predecessor, the Invincible-class. It's 200 meters in length, which makes it about 2.5 times as large as a football field. The vessels of this class are the largest warships ever built in the United Kingdom. Lead ship HMS Queen Elizabeth was commissioned on the 7th of December 2017, and second ship HMS Prince of Wales is currently under construction with planned commissioning in 2020.
Number 2.
The Kuznetsov-class aircraft carriers were the last class of aircraft carriers designed for the Soviet Navy. Two hulls were laid down in the Ukraine before the Soviet Union collapsed. Kuznetsov serves today in the Russian Navy. The other was bought by China and named as Liaoning. After refit, it was commissioned on the 25th of September 2012. The Type 001A aircraft carrier, or CV-17 aircraft carrier, was launched on the 26th of April 2017 for the People's Liberation Army Navy of China. It's the country's second aircraft carrier after the completion of Liaoning and the first built domestically. It has a length of 315 meters and will have displacement of 70,000 tons when fully loaded. It will be able to carry 48 aircraft and is expected to be commissioned in 2019. The Type 002 aircraft carrier is a second-generation Chinese aircraft carrier design. The Type 002 will feature an integrated electric propulsion system that will allow the operation of electromagnetic launch catapults similar to the electromagnetic aircraft launch system used by the Ford class of the United States. It could have displacement of 85,000 tons and has an estimated commissioning in 2023.
Number 1.
Ford-class supercarriers are being built to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers from 2017. The new vessels have a hull similar to the Nimitz carriers, but has major technological upgrades. Ford-class has displacement of 100,000 tons and has a length of 337 meters, making the vessels of this class the largest in the world, along with ships of the Nimitz class. The ships of the Ford's class are expected to be in service with the U.S. Navy till 2065 and use state-of-the-art technologies. Ford class uses electromagnetic aircraft launch system, EMALS, instead of steam-actuated catapults of Nimitz, but has newly designed reactors. Two Bechtel A-1B nuclear reactors producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz class. A lot of automation is in place and potential deployment of railgun and laser weapons are planned for the future. The first ship of this class is CVN-78 USS Gerald R. Ford. It cost about $12.8 billion. The U.S. Navy accepted delivery of the USS Gerald R. Ford on May 31, 2017. CVN-79 John F. Kennedy and CVN-80 Enterprise are under construction with commissioning planned in 2024 and 2027, respectively. CVN-81 is still to be named and is planned for commissioning in 2030.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.